Bonjour!
Bonjour!
No.
Time for bladder check.
Check.
So it's a show?
It's a lifestyle. It's a religion.
My emotions! My emotions!
I'm still French.
Ouais, c'est pas faux.
I'm a woman, Mary. I can be as contrary as I choose.
Non, moi je crois qu'il faut que vous arrêtiez d'essayer de dire des trucs.
Hello, hi, I'm Laura. I'm gonna watch Avatar The Last Airbender Season 1, Episode 12. Before beginning, it's really windy today, so I'm sorry if it's disturbing for the noise. Maybe you're gonna hear some wind and all of that. Sorry for that. Also, quick reminder, if you want to have more episodes of Avatar, you can go check my Patreon. On Patreon, you have episodes at least 1 week sooner than on YouTube, and you have an extended reaction part for Avatar and the first episodes right there of the season 1. It was 5 minutes longer, something like that. So if you can be interested by that, go check my Patreon. Thank you a lot to those of you who were glad to have me reacting to Avatar. You are a lot new on my channel because of Avatar. Hello! Thank you to those of you who joined this channel. Thank you for that. I hope that you love my reactions, my thoughts about this show. Thank you also for your comments. You're a lot to comment and to tell me information, you know, that I didn't have. Especially about martial arts, you know, that airbenders, earthbenders, firebenders and waterbenders are using. You told me the fact that all of them are using different martial arts, and that was interesting, you know, to learn. You told me also about the age of each character. That was also interesting because I didn't understand that Zuko and Aang were that, you know, separate. With the age, the fact that Zuko was the older and Aang was the younger, that I knew, but I thought that Zuko and Sokka, for example, they had the same age, and in fact, no, Zuko is even older than Sokka. You told me also that, you know, you didn't have my reaction video about it yet on YouTube. I think that you have only the 5 first reaction videos for now on YouTube, and you already told me that you didn't like the episode 11 that I just watched, you know, that was the last one that I watched. I can understand that because, you know, in the episode 11, not a lot of things are happening, and you can think that this fight between these two clans, you know, these two tribes was not interesting. But, you know, like some episodes that I already watched, I think that it was symbolic and it was interesting because it's giving us informations for the future, you know, it's building what can happen in the future. For me, it gave me the information that we have refugees. I mean, that's a normal thing, that's a natural thing. When you think that you have a war, that you have battles, that you have civilians and all, of course you're gonna have refugees. But right there, we saw these refugees and we saw that they are not only desperate because of the situation, because of what is happening, but they are also fighting against each other. They are not united. And Katara said something about the fact that it's the job of Aang, you know, as the Avatar, to unite people. And I think that it was interesting, you know, to learn this information about the refugee, but also about that job that Aang has, reuniting people, having them, you know, united, maybe to fight the Fire Lord. I'm thinking of something like that, especially because of the comet coming. You know what I think about that? The fact that I'm not sure that Aang can learn everything, you know, about all of the different bending before the comet coming, you know. I think that we have to deal with the comet and then learning all of the different bendings. I'm really more thinking of something like that. And because of the last episode, because of the fact that now I know that Aang is supposed to unite people, to make them work together, to make them united. Can it be something, you know, that we can use for this comet? Like, the comet is made with earth, you know, it's a rock. And like with the episode with the earthbenders, you know, which were into that gel chip, you know, these earthbenders, they used this coal, you know, because it was made of earth. This rock, you know, the comet, can they do something about that? And it's fire, so waterbenders, can they do something about that comet? I don't know why, but I have this theory. these two theories, one being dealing with the comet first and the second one, maybe people can unite to deal with this comet, and that can be the beginning of all of them being united against the Fire Lord. I know I'm going far with my theories, but it's like that. And really, the episode 11, okay, for the story, was maybe, you know, not interesting. I thought that it was a great episode, but I can understand why some of you didn't think that it was a good one. But I really think that even into this little episode, we are learning stuff about the situation right there with the refugees, but also about what Aang is supposed to do, what Aang is gonna be forced to do, what Aang can use. New allies, new friends, things like that. And right there, I think that it was about Aang. You have to unite people, you have to make them work together. They are so used with this war, you know, to deal with the Fire Nation just by themselves, you know, in all of their different nations, tribes, you know, territories, that they didn't work together against, or maybe they did it, but they are not doing it anymore, and they have to work again together. I'm thinking of that. Okay, I'm gonna watch the episode 12 right now, and I think at least two more episodes today, so let's go! Oh, and some of you are not happy that my intros are so long. Get used to it, I'm not gonna change that. I love to talk about my theories, about my thoughts, about the show that I'm watching, so get used to it, or not, and if not, I'm sorry for you. But I'm not sorry for making long intros. Light is weird. Okay, you're dreaming.
I need you. Why did you disappear? I didn't mean to.
I need you. It was the other avatars, you know, before him. Oh, really, just air people.
This was in my dream. We shouldn't go to the market.
What happened in your dream?
Food eats people.
No.
Also, Momo can talk.
Oh, I would love that.
Stone is approaching from the north.
Is it a symbolic stone? Okay.
Mr. Zuko, consider the safety of the crew.
The safety of the crew doesn't matter.
That's not nice.
Finding the avatar is far more important.
It's going to be a terrible storm.
Well, it's your joints against my brain.
No, 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 I trust our joints. I have the same things, you know. Cold days are coming, you know, when winter is coming. I have the same with my... It's blocking, you know. Oh, huh? Don't judge me.
You better learn some respect, or I will teach it to you.
What do you know about respect?
He's right, and be careful, Zuko.
What should I expect from a spoiled prince?
A banished prince. For sure, you need his help, you need to calm down.
The Avatar disappeared for 100 years. You turned your back on the world.
Don't yell at him.
Stop yelling. You're yelling at everyone you.
Then I guess I must have imagined the last 100 years of war and suffering. That's right, keep flying.
He's feeling guilty. Maybe it's not just about, you know, his people disappearing, but also because of why he was at this place, you know, and the fact that we have a storm right now. It's reminding him stuff, maybe? Or it's gonna bring flashbacks?
I'll never forget the day the monks told me I was the Avatar. First and foremost, then he gotta get out quick.
Yes, that's how you know.
He would have told you of your identity when you turned 16, but there are troubling signs.
I knew that you told him earlier because you knew that something was gonna happen. Oh, interesting. The thing about the toys, you know, because of his past lives, it shows these toys. That's how you know that this baby is gonna be the Avatar.
Complicated young man. He has been through much.
Oh yeah! Are we gonna know why you were banished?
How do you expect them to defeat a powerful Earth kingdom with time?
Which one of you is the Fire Lord?
They'll be used as a distraction to use as bait and fresh meat.
You can't sacrifice an entire division like that. Those soldiers love and defend our nation.
Zuko, you were thinking like that? Defending soldiers? People?
So you're obsessed with him with the Avatar?
That's a flashback episode.
Well, I didn't know how to feel about it. Now that you're the Avatar, it's kind of an unfair advantage for whichever team you're on. But I'm still the same. Nothing's changed. I can't play. That's the only fair way.
But she loves to play.
Very interesting move, young one.
What do you mean?
That's the game that the uncle is playing, you know? You need the lotus.
No, as long as I am his guardian, I will decide when he trains.
The Fire Lord became very angry with him.
Oh, so you're the Fire Lord.
I
want to see your face.
That's right. Was the Fire Lord whom he had disrespected?
He's gonna fight his father? Oh, you can't kill him. That's your father. And he can't kill you. That's why he banished you.
You and Aang must be separated. The Avatar will be sent away to the Eastern Air Temple to complete his training.
Oh! That's why you were... You left by yourself. You run away. The storm. That's destiny. Now you can change stuff.
He begged for mercy.
He begged?
Please, Father, I only have the Fire Nation's best interest at heart.
You will fight for your honor.
You didn't want to fight.
You will learn respect. And suffering will be your teacher.
Who is the girl? You know she's at the first, the scar and the banishment.
Sent to capture the Avatar. But the important thing is, the Avatar gives Zuko hope.
You changed a lot, for sure.
I'm going to find them. I'm going with you.
I'm staying here.
You're gonna go back in the storm, fighting your demons? You didn't mean what you said, Zuko. You want to save people. You care about the soldiers. Your people.
The Avatar! Let him go. We need to get this ship to safety.
Hurry! Eye contact.
Oh, you're alive. You owe this boy an apology.
He doesn't have to apologize. I'm done dwelling on the past. Really? I can't make guesses about how things would have turned out if I hadn't run away. I'm here now, I'm going to make the most of it.
Thank you for saving my life, Avatar.
Do you hear that? It stopped raining.
Oh, is somebody coming back? You. I love this episode so much. Oh, all of what we learned into this episode. That was a flashback episode, for sure. Two answers about the past of Aang and of Zuko respond to some questions that I and all of the viewers, you know, asked to themselves during the first episodes. I was wondering, you know, why Aang was at this place during the first episode. I mean, why he was right there during the storm? Why it happened like that? Why was he so far away, you know, from his people? That's why. Now we know. He ran away because the monks, you know, of his people wanted to send him away because they wanted him to learn Avatar stuff and to not play, to not be a kid anymore, but he was a kid. Still right there. That's why also he ran away, and I have trouble to blame him for running away. He was a kid. Kids are doing that kind of stupid stuff, you know, when they Oh! No, I'm sorry! I said to you during the intro that there is a lot of wind today, and something, you know, on my balcony was beginning to fly away. No! I'm talking about airbending, and this is happening. I was saying, Aang is a kid, so he got mad and he ran away. Kids are doing that. That's wrong, for sure. Don't do that, kids. But I can understand his reasons, you know, and now I can understand why he was right there. I don't have this question, you know, anymore into my head. Zuko's past. That was weird, you know, to see him without the scar, with more hair also. You know, he doesn't have only his things, but he has hair all around his face. And what happened? You know, when I was thinking about why he was banished, I was thinking about all of the possibilities why he was banished. And for me, if he was banished, it would have been, you know, because he did something wrong against the Fire Nation. Doing something wrong against the Fire Nation, it would have been great for us, you know, maybe. Zuko, in fact, was with us since the beginning and we didn't know it. That's more complicated than that. He was with the Fire Nation and he wanted to protect Fire soldiers. You know, on the contrary, I was so wrong with my theory because on the contrary, he was not doing something against the Fire Nation. What he said during that reunion, you know, during that meeting with the generals and all, it was for the Fire Nation. It was for the Fire people. He is really involved with the Fire Nation, with his people. He's really acting, you know, like a leader of his people. He wants to protect them, to not send young soldiers right there just to be killed. That's great, you know, I'm admiring that. And that's also disturbing the theories that I could have made, you know, if my first theory about why he was banished was right. That changing things, you know, is really a Fire Prince who wants to rule the Fire Nation to protect his people, his soldiers. The duel, you know, that he had against his father, we didn't see his face. That's gonna be a mystery until when? I want to see the Fire Lord's face. But okay, we didn't see his face, and the fact that he didn't even try to fight his father. That moment was so sad. Like, we saw that he was crying, you know, we saw that he admires, I think, his father so much that he was ready to beg him for mercy, to tell him, I don't want to fight you, I don't want even to try to fight you. And his father made him this scar and banished him because of that. Because of what happened during the reunion, but also because his son didn't want to fight, and that was a proof of weakness. Zuko couldn't stay there. We know, you know, because of this duel that Zuko had with the general some episodes earlier, we know that you're supposed to fight until one of the person who is fighting is dying, you know? So That's Yami Hang that the Fire Lord chose during that moment to banish his son and to make him this car. I'm confused by this other flashback, you know, that we saw of Zuko when he was looking like that at the ocean with someone with an hand on his shoulder. I think that it was his father. It's really representing well, I think, the relationship that he has with his father. What we learned during this episode, it's the fact that he admires his father, he loves him, he wants his father to respect him, he wants his father to be proud of him. He has also good memories with his father. Oh, the girl also, that was weird. I don't know why really I focused on her during that moment, but the fact that she was, you know, we had Uncle Iroh and in front of him we had the girl. Is it her sister or someone like that? For me, she's someone important, she's someone that we have to keep an eye on because she was at the first, at the front row, you know, so she was important. I'm voting for a sister. So we had these flashbacks about Aang and about Zuko, and that was interesting, but we had also what happened during this episode, and that was the two of them fighting in a way, you know, against what happened during these flashbacks, you know. The fact that Zuko began this episode by saying that he doesn't care about his crew dying or not, about their safety, because in fact the only thing that he cares about is taking the Avatar, because it's gonna be the only way to have back his honor and all of that, you know, to go back to the Fire Nation. But at the end, we can see that his natural instinct is to save his people no matter what, even if it means to put himself in danger, because he's like that and he can't be like his father, you know. He can't be like his father can want him to be. Do you understand what I mean? That was interesting, and Zuko also understood it, because at the end he's saying to his crew, we're not going after the Avatar, it wouldn't be safe for us. So he understood that during this episode, you know, he felt that flashback. And same for Aang. The storm was representing, you know, a trauma for him. What happened during the storm, and right there he went back on the storm and he managed to deal with it, you know, and to save his friends and all. And also to understand that he can't live into the past again and again and feel guilty about what happened, and he has to face the present. To not feel guilty about not saving the people before, that's something important for sure, but to understand that right now you can still save people, like Sokka and this fisherman, that's also really important and what matters now. That was great. Oh, and also this information about the Avatar. You know, the fact that when you are a baby, the toys that you are choosing them according to your past lives, and that's why all of the Avatars are choosing the same toys, you know, the four relics, they said. That was interesting also. Oh, I really loved this episode. So many informations! Maybe I'm gonna put my full reaction part, you know, for this episode on my Patreon. I think that there are so many informations that it would be better to put everything. Okay, so it's all for this episode of Avatar, the episode 12. Me, I'm gonna watch two more episodes today. So it's all for you for today, and it's all for me for now. So bye for now. Bye.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me you built a time machine? Crazy.